Hey. 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 On another episode of Keeping Up with Queen P. This is proudly sponsored by Jet. This is from The Fix. So, I had to have a serious chat with you guys because I've been MIA since June. The last video I posted was at the end of June. I promised to deliver another video, but I never came through. I tried vlogging. July, I tried to vlog. I went to the coast, I tried to vlog that. I had my 21st birthday party in August. I also tried to vlog that, but it wasn't a success. Within this month of September, I also tried to vlog other videos, but it wasn't a success. And here I am, back and better, with a whole venting session. In all honesty, I have really not been okay. What happened was I experienced a bit of failure in June. That's when I basically had like imposter syndrome. And from that failure, I don't want to talk about what the failure was, but from that failure, I just basically thought that I wasn't good enough to do anything, you know, and it hindered my content creation, you know, doing YouTube and all of that. And I really just had to sit down with myself, and like, I've really been on a journey since June till September now. I've been on a serious journey with myself and really realizing that I should stop holding on to things, and I should stop attaching to things, and I should leave the world alone, and that life really stems from within me. When I say all these things, I basically mean that I create the life that I want for myself. Because I held on to that failure, it held me back from my full potential. So I just really had to sit down like with myself and just be like, when am I gonna stop feeling sorry for myself, you know? Failures are meant to happen for me to grow, and unfortunately some things are out of my control, but I need to leave it alone. That failure is the special ingredient to me. So I'm 21 now, and I really learned that I really deserve everything and anything. Let me also know in the comments how you guys have been doing. So basically today what we're gonna do is, I just got dressed up because, I mean, you need to look good to feel good. I took out my hair, and my hair, like half of my hair is out, the other half is not out. So we're gonna take out the other half, and then we're going to go to the salon to get my hair blown out. And that's basically it that I have planned for the day, and then also to study. I might be going out, but I'm not sure because, yeah, there's a bit of financial issues. Piano. Fungo milango, nakosa piano, piano. So beautiful. So basically why I'm here is I want someone to take pictures of me, so I am putting it into existence that I'm going to find someone to take pictures for me. So let's go. So I told you guys I found somebody, and somebody took amazing hot pictures of me. Like, I look like such a snack, honestly speaking. And now we are on our way home. Yeah,
it fell down. But basically, we are on our way home because I did not eat this whole day, and I'm going to celebrate also my friend. And if you're gonna go drinking, my mom always says before you take a shot, you need to eat. So I'm gonna go home, make something to eat, and then after that, we are logging off where I don't know. But yeah, let us depart.
Hi guys.
Hi guys.
How you guys doing?
Wow, it's Rachel's
friend. And she ran away even. Yeah. So we got some snacks. You said what? We're creating memories.
We're creating memories. We only need one because the aim. Hey.
So right now we're in Glenhill. We are going, making our way up to the rooftop. I never knew people could chill there. Same. So apparently this is a regular for birthday girl and Caroline. We are just tag alongs today. So let's go.
Throws are open.
Throws are open. Friday.
What's up? We are at the rooftop. Look at the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Benzig City. Oh. Guys, I feel like such a
rebel. Per. Yes. By day.
Y'all are wearing a skirt, man.
What's that?
That was scary.
No, it really was scary. Give us the shopping haul. Uh-huh.
We got some Fritos. Mm.
Got some Fritos.
0 grams of
sugar.
I don't know what. What that is.
Mm-hmm.
This is for Rachel.
Uh-huh.
But this is, I brought this because y'all know Dorito Girlie.
Mm-hmm.
Dorito Jackie.
Her.
Then we brought cake.
Mm-hmm.
We're not saying for happy birthday later again. Because, and Rachel, because she's a, like, a healthy girlie, have. She has like food.
No, hey guys, so this is Rach.
We're supposed to buy a cake.
How are you feeling?
Mm. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Too hard to handle. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Rachel. Happy birthday to you.
The singer of the group. Eight.
Yeah.
Ooh, cheers.
Cheers. Okay, cheers.
Taco.
Hi guys, so I'm in the bathroom now. I think I'm alone. I am going for my first psychologist or psychology appointment. I am super excited because I really haven't been okay and I took the step to really get my mental health checked. You cannot be winning if your mind is not okay.
So your girl is back and better from her therapy session. I had a really, really great time in therapy today. Today we learned cognitive therapy. What cognitive therapy is all about is basically learning how to control your inner locus instead of your external locus. So to give you an example, today somebody told me that someone thinks that I am ugly. And personally, I know I'm not ugly. Like, I know I'm really, really, really beautiful. And I also can't control external things that happen around me, and I can't control other people's perceptions of me. However, I can control how I react to that. So basically, that's just what cognitive therapy is all about: changing those irrational thoughts to rational thoughts. Because my therapist just basically told me, as a human being, you're not supposed to make yourself feel bad. You know, you are your biggest supporter and you are your biggest critique. Life is already difficult, so why are you being so hard on yourself? So the moment you have thoughts that make you feel bad, that's when you know, I gotta switch things up. So yeah, you know, I told her everything that's going on, and I was there in 2019, and when I was there in 2019, she diagnosed me for mixed depression and anxiety. So basically, what she gave me, this quiz, and this quiz basically just determines where your mental state is at. So we're gonna do another reevaluation to see if I still suffer from mixed depression and anxiety.
Dumelang, sambanani. Good morning, guys. I hope you guys can hear me. Right now, what we are going to do today is I am rushing to my doctor's appointment, because when your mind is not okay, it affects some parts of your body. I am like 8 minutes late for my appointment. Yeah, let's go.
This one is two at the same time, three times a day. This one is for pain and inflammation.
So when I was at my psychologist today, she noticed something about me, that whenever I attach myself to unchangeable events, I tend not to eat. So that's why I went to the doctor, because from my mind, it went to my body. If I change, I got to go see my street.